everyone, welcome to a game of Dota 2. It is the second game of the day, and this is day number 24 of StarLadder Star Series, and a day that we are going to see 6 matches in total. Now, I already said this is game number 2, so we're only going to see 5 more games. A very important game, a very important day, I should say, for a lot of the teams. Most importantly, it is Navi's and Empire's chance today to still be going to Kiev. If Mouseports loses their 2 games today, which are going to be against No Tidehunter and Navi, so not the easiest of contestants. But if they lose them, Navi and Empire still have a chance to go to Kiev, because then they would be on even ground with Mouseports. But those games are all going to be happening after this. After this game first, it's going to be Navi versus Empire, then No Tidehunter versus Mouse, then 3D Clan versus No Tidehunter, and then Navi versus Mouse. But first, 4FC versus Power Rangers, and we are going to see these two teams going up against each other. Before we are going to do that, though, we're going to check quickly their points. These points are, of course, of today. The previous game that we saw is not yet updated in this score list. We see 4FC, they're doing really well. They have lost 4 games alone in total, and that is really not that much. That is the same as Navi and Empire have, so in theory, they can still get ahead and go to the shared 5th place at the moment, depending on if Mouseports loses their games today. We're gonna see if they can actually do that. It is a long way to go for them. They've only played 7 games so far, and all the other teams have played way more than that. So that is a reason why I don't mention them, because there's just so much more games for them to be playing. We're gonna see how they're gonna do up against Power Rangers. Power Rangers, they have got themselves 10 games played, 3 games won, 7 lost, and we're gonna see if they can get a bit of extra points, because they could use those to make sure they don't have to play regulation matches at the end of the season to not be going to the Pro Series, because the bottom 4 have the chance to go to Pro Series, with the bottom 2 getting dropped there regardless, and the other 2 having to play regulation matches. So we are gonna see which one of these 2 teams is gonna get those points that are up for grabs. 3 points for each win, and you have to face every team once, so 15 games in total. No points if you lose. We're gonna see the Wisp Bat, Nyx, and Coddle being banned out, so no real surprise there, with the Darkseer being the first pickup. And Power Rangers already securing 2 heroes for themselves that are, of course, very strong, the Queen of Pain and the Lifestealer. It does give 4FC the chance to pick up a couple of supports that are normally picked up fairly early, especially if you're going to go for those supports that can shut down the lifesteal, for example, a Bane. But they could also go for a Magnus still if they want to. Shadow Demon is still in the pool. Rubick is still in the pool. Could also go for Gyrocopter Bane. I mean, we've seen all the combinations before, and we're going to see what they're going to be playing this game. Remaining. As we have got stand-ins playing for 4FC. As I already said, we also got stand-ins for Power Rangers, though, the same stand-in as we saw yesterday. We'll see how he is going to be doing in this game. And, well, they're going into reserve time for this pick. Let's see what they're going to be picking up. Well, if they're going to go do something unorthodox, they could already pick up a jungle hero if they want to. But I don't think that 4FC really likes to have that. Like, 4FC, you have to understand something from the team. The team is mostly consistent out of like, their name says 4 friends plus really. Their team is basically friends. They don't really scrim. At least not all that much, but from what I've been told, they are just a group of friends that likes to play and have got decent skill level, obviously. Otherwise, they wouldn't be here. And, Radiant team pick. Yeah, so I'm not sure how much they practice, and in that sense, how much they practice draft. Drafting against other teams, but they pick up the Bane and the Magnus, so that's 2 heroes that we were kind of expecting. 2 heroes that can shut down that Lifestealer with the Fiend's Grip, with the reverse polarity, and we'll see what Power Rangers has to answer to that one. We're probably gonna see them picking up a support like a Rubick or a Shadow Demon, or maybe they still really want to pick up some of their other lanes. But I would be quite surprised to see that happening, because it basically gives 4FC the chance to ban out all these supports that they don't want to be playing themselves, and they have the first pickup. So yeah, so it's gonna be a Rubick, so no real surprise there. We're gonna see 4FC probably ban something out like a Lina or a Lashrek, because that goes very well together with a Rubick and a Lifestealer. Maybe even some solo lanes, considering Lifestealer can be on the safe lane, Queen of Pain mid, and then they still need some solo lanes to be there. But it's gonna be more supports first. It's gonna be the Shadow Demon. I just decided to drink some water. Apparently I was more thirsty than I thought. Normally I can do that without you really noticing it all that much, but... well. Phantom Knights are gonna get banned out here, or that, of course, works well together with a Bane. But, but yeah, with 4FC banning out the Shadow Demon, it kind of limits their options for supports as well. Well, you would kind of expect maybe something like a Lashrek or a Lina still to go for the lineup, for the Split Earth or like Tracker Ray to follow up on the Nightmare would be very decent, especially also if you're going to combine that with a reverse polarity. But the same thing goes for Jakiro, so I guess supports are plenty still left for 4 FC. But it really depends on what they're expecting Power Rangers to be still wanting. If they still think the Power Rangers wants another support, like, how much do you want to really ban out for that kind of stuff? How much do you want to deny to them? It's going to be a Nature's Prophet that's going to be banned out by 4FC next. Of course, that's a combination with a Lifestealer that we see often. Just jump themselves into the Nature's Prophet and then just go all over the map. And one thing that I wanted to mention also is that the Phantom Lancer being banned out is basically a reply to that Shadow Demon being banned out. Shadow Demon is considered, well, it's not really a counter, but he is very strong if there is also a Phantom Lancer in the game, if you can just make illusions out of the illusions of the Phantom Lancer, so, and those illusions create their own illusions, so you can have your own Phantom Lancer army. We have the Lashrak being banned out, so no real surprise there, though they do deny it to themselves in that case, but apparently they have other plans. We still have both teams having space for Jungle Hero if they really want to. Even 4FC, they already got the Darkseer, so in theory they already got it themselves a Jungle Hero, so they are secure in that case. Well, let's see what we're gonna see 4FC pick up next.
10 seconds remaining.
A ban out next, I should say, because the next one is a ban. Is it gonna be Jungle Hero? Or is it gonna be another support? Like a Lina? But if they ban out Alina, they're gonna have the chance to have that Jakiro being banned out, perhaps. It's gonna be a jungler, it's gonna be the Chen that gets banned out. Radiant team. But the fact that the Lashrak got banned out by Power Rangers kinda could give away that there is indeed gonna be a jungle hero on the side of Power Rangers, because if Power Rangers ban out supports, it means that they're not afraid for themselves to not be left with any strong support, meaning that they could be going for that jungle hero, but we'll see. They ban out the Gyrocopter, I did mention the Gyrocopter, of course. A strong carry together with the Bane, but no longer in the pool. We do still have Luna if they want to be playing that one. And of course a lot of other carries still in the pool as well. But first I think we're gonna see support Lina being picked up. There is a Lina. Light Strike Array to follow up on that Nightmare, and of course also Reverse Polarity, Light Strike Array and Dragon Slave to follow up, and just a Laguna Blade just for whoever is left on high enough HP, the most tanky of the bunch, which is probably going to be the Lifestealer. A very nice nice thing there. The only thing though is the Rubik on the side of Power Rangers. If you look at the lineup for 4FC, I mean, you can't really steal anything bad from the Lina. You can't really steal anything bad from the Magnus. You can steal a Fiend Script very easily because it's a channeled spell. And the Darkseer, also very strong steel spells from. So Rubik is going to have a ball here. He's going to be just fine. He's going to be fun. He's going to be having fun. For sure. And Power Rangers, are they going to go for that Jungle Hero? There's still an Enchantress in the pool, of course, as well as an Enigma. So they could be picking up either of those two. Unless they want to go still for a Tri-Lane, in which case, well, their Lina is now being denied, so maybe a Jakiro or another hero that we don't normally see all that much, like a Crystal Maiden or a Venomancer. We've seen extra Crystal Maiden yesterday, I believe. But one of those heroes could still be a support. It's going to be a Silencer. It's going to probably be a support Silencer, though. It could be a carrying Silencer with Lifestealer on the safe lane and an aggressive Tri-Lane on the top, but or a Silencer mid and Queen of Pain on the safe lane solo. I mean, it could be, but I'm not really expecting it. Silencer, I think he found most of his use in the laning stage, and then just his global silence more as a utility hero than anything else, and a semi-carry potential later on in the game perhaps, but if you get a BKB against him, it's easily sorted. Can't really do you much damage to you inside those fights. Gonna see 4FC picking up their last hero. They kind of have, well, they have an offlane, they have a mid lane, they have got two supports, but they kind of miss their damage dealer. It's still gonna be a Luna, the one that I mentioned also. And that's gonna be the last pickup. They have an okay lineup if they get those RPs up, but I think for now I like the versatility for Power Rangers more. They've got late game, they've got mid game. Same thing goes for 4FC, but you've got your Late game with a Lifestealer versus Luna. I think I like Lifestealer a bit more lately. You of course got your RP. I mean, there's nothing against that RP ever. Unless there's a Rubick on the other side of the team, which is indeed the case. And how are you going to be able to RP if you have a silencer on the opposing team who's going to just watch you constantly to know when you are actually going to be trying to RP and then silence you right before that happens? Wow, sorry for my silence there. I was slightly distracted by the chat. I sunk to a new low.
10 seconds.
Anyways, there's still that Enigma. The one that I mentioned. So that kind of means the silencer, he is gonna be... He's gonna be mid. I think he's gonna be mid, and then Queen of Pain, long lane, lifestealer, Rubick, bottom lane. Possibly? I think we're gonna get see still see a ZXC Queen of Pain though. And ZXC is normally mid. We have a disconnect from everybody, so we will be having a remake by the looks of it. Don't know why, but we will. Let's see how fast we can get that remake going so that we don't have to wait for that long. And of course, we can keep everything in the. Oops. I know I was in the wrong channel. Oops. There. Okay. That's supposed to be in channel 1. Hey! Oh! Sorry. Here you go. See the whole map. Well, it's not really a map. It's more like the login thing. Just waiting for everybody to be here. So unless the last one of 4FC, that has to come soon though. Eros Loco is the last one to have to join. And then we can go. We have got a lot of team fight on both teams, RPs and Black Holes. Now the thing is, I think that Rubick can make all the difference. Ah, here's the difference for the reason for the remake. The stand-in for Power Rangers has been replaced by the actual player from Power Rangers. So that's that. There is the last one. And we can go. Hi, we're here. So it's going to be all pick phase, of course, as everybody already drafted.
Queen of Pain.
So it is going to be ZXC on as Queen of Pain. I'm really quite curious to see what that silencer is going to be. And if, for example, Kat's going to play it. He has been known to play also the Rubick, but Kat's also the player that sometimes plays support solo mid, so who knows? Maybe we're gonna see Moon in that, Kat in that silencer role. We have everybody picked up their hero, but it takes a bit long before we actually swap ourselves into that map, so that we can actually see the entire game. Go on, you can do it. We actually have to wait all the time? I guess we have to. So we have got indeed Kat playing the silencer, and Nanika on the Rubick. I'll just go over everybody at the moment that you actually see them, because that's a bit better. So Power Rangers, Radiant side. ZXE gonna be playing the Queen of Pain, Moon on his Lifestealer, Nanik on the Rubick. Cheshire Kat will be playing the Enigma, and Kat will be on the Silencer. So that is the entire lineup from Power Rangers, and it looks like we are gonna see a support silencer. And Cheshire Kat gonna be going into the jungle. Looks like they're gonna leave the top lane entirely open in that case. Just have a tri lane bottom. Jungle or Enigma, who can, if needed, go top. And go towards the jungle first, and then just have tri lane bottom. But we'll see. We're gonna jump ourselves to 4FC, who are playing with stand ins today. We have Eros Loco first. He's gonna be playing the Darkseer. It's gonna be Nose playing the Magnus. I have been told that we should be watching out for him. Mostly because he is a player that can all of a sudden make the biggest plays you've ever seen. Apparently. Hearsay. So we'll see if that's gonna be his job. If he's actually gonna be able to do that. He got pulled Tangos. He's going for a fast bottle and he will have it fairly fast as he's only needing about 150 gold. We have Boomski playing the Lina support. Iconoclast or Matrim is gonna be playing the Bane. He is 4 FC's manager, so that's why he's manager Iconoclast. But he is, of course, formerly player for MTW, and he will also be my co-caster for the rest of the day for the matches after this one. It will be Krilly playing the Luna, and we're gonna see tri lane top, safe tri lane. We just caught a class placing a ward up the high ground to give some extra vision for Nose. And it looks like Eros Loco has scouted out that he's gonna be up against the tri lane and decided not that he doesn't want to be up against that, so he's just gonna go into the jungle and get his levels up a bit. At some point, if needed, he will be able to. He's just gonna be the same thing as Enigma. He will be able to go to the bottom lane if needed, but for now, he'll get more things done on that in the jungle rather than sitting on a top lane not being able to get an experience range. So we'll see how that's gonna go. In the meantime, in the mid lane, this is the lane where I'm gonna be expecting some action, because basically this is the only lane where people are meeting each other. But also, well, both of these have, of course, an escape mechanism, and I believe this is the same encounter that we saw in the previous game, as in Magnus versus Queen of Pain, and we have, of course, seen that before. And it's like with both heroes having harass mechanisms, having escape mechanisms. In theory, neither should die, but if someone does, I mean, this is just a battle of the skills for now. Although Queen of Pain should, in theory, be getting a bit ahead of the Magnus, purely because she can harass a bit better than the Magnus can. But Magnus does have his bottle now, and we'll be continuing to bottle crow that. So we'll see how, if he can stay alive long enough. Now, the thing is, of course, EXE, we know him from crazy dives and jukes. He might try to snipe off the courier if he realizes that it's coming, as we have got a sheep coming with the package. We have got a normal donkey coming with the bottle for the Queen of Pain already, so that is going to be that one. Sheep's going to be fine, bottle is delivered. And the tri-lane top is already pushing. They have got, of course, that level 1 in Lunar Blessing, so they do have that extra pushing power. As they also have a bit of extra power from the Dragon Slave to clear out the creep wave. And they're just going to make sure that they're going to be the first one to take towers down. Now they realize Power Rangers does it is that's being done, so they may be trying to do the same thing. As Rubick is actually gonna TP top, maybe they want to try to defend their tower. He has, of course, got that Fate Bolt, but is it gonna be enough? I don't think so. It's gonna be enough to pull the creep wave back, that's for sure. And he's indeed gonna, or is he gonna try that? Yes, he is. Tower is gonna be still cleaning out those on creeps, so. Oh, Boomski! Careful there, Boomski. That tower hurts. Tower not in the direct range just yet. Almost, though. One more push to go, and it will be happening. Eros Loco also coming towards the bottom lane. And is also gonna be trying to stop the pusher tower from being pushed down. He has a bit more luck because, well, luck. He can do it a bit better because he is, of course, an hero with an escape. And the Iron Shell will be able to help out as well, as Moon is just gonna harass him a bit. But shouldn't be all of too much trouble. Here comes the push again. And this should be the tower going down. Fortification being used still. Iconoclast tanking up the creep wave because he can. Looking for a Nightmare, finds it. Rubick, is there gonna be a Light Strike Rage to follow up on that one? Looks like it's gonna hit still. Losing Beam is gonna hit there as well. And Nick is gonna be in trouble and he's gonna go down. Bane to pick up the first blood. Iconoclast able to upgrade the courier with that if he wants to. Extra courier is already upgraded, but it's gonna be able to pick up some boots. Jesus, that laugh from that Bane. That lasts long. But he is gonna be fine, as we see Nose getting harassed a bit more. But he's got a full bottle again. ZXE, is he gonna dive this though? Nope, he shouldn't. One bottle charge left for him. It's not going to be enough to survive. There will be, of course, a 4-minute rune soon again. Nose will be the one to try and get that as well as a ZXC. For both, it's pretty important because both have an empty bottle, or should have. Magnus is, of course, there we go, empty bottle. But there's going to be a rotation. There's going to be Iconoclast and Boomski coming in to that middle lane. They're going to be trying to take down the Queen of Pain. They have got the Nightmare and the Lightstrike Array. There's the bottle again. Actually, Courier gets sent back without the bottle. Got some boots to the Queen of Pain. There's a Nightmare, still hits. Boomski, follow up the Lightstrike Array, and there is gonna be a stun, and that is gonna be another kill on the board for 4 FC. Queen of Pain drops, Nose picking up the kill, and he should be able to pick up the level 4 or the 4-minute rune as well, as there's nobody else to try and get that. In the meantime, Iris Loco farming on the bottom lane. I say farming because he's actually getting somewhere right now. He's still level 4 though. I believe that's about the same level. He was level 3 actually when he came towards the bottom lane. But he's able to do something, able to harass Moon a bit, who is at 25-5. We can't really count Iris Loco's last hits, his actual last hits though, because he of course went to the small camp and he farmed that one a bit, and those creeps just give a lot less gold than the creeps in on the lane. As we're gonna see Boomski maybe trying to go for a kill on the Rubik. Rubik is being offlaning here since the tower went down. Wait a second. Iris Loco might be in some trouble here, because here comes the Enigma as well. He has of course got a Malefice. He's surging himself up, but here comes the Malefice. The curse is still there. Iris Loco in a lot of trouble trying to get himself out of here, but I don't think he's gonna be able to do that, and that's gonna be a kill. It is gonna be Cheshire Cat that picks it up. And then it's just slight overextension from Iris Loco. The first kill on the set of Power Rangers. As Nose has not yet got his level 6. And it's actually Queen of Pain that is... now they're both level 6. Well, that's that. I was gonna say, it's actually Queen of Pain still that slightly had an experience. Even though there is a kill, of course, up on her, and there's no kill up on Nose. Just the harassment alone, and of course the denies making a difference there. The denies not even that much, because there's 3 denies on both. But just the harassment in that case. There's Loco's gonna be able to be safe here. The push is gonna come in though, it's just from 2 heroes. They can't really push that fast, and an Iron Shell would do the job to push it back out again. Not even needed, I think. Well, maybe it is. Creep Wave is far away. A lot of damage being done. There comes the Iron Shell and the Creep Wave. Let's see what they can do with that. Looks like we are gonna see them backing off. There is a ping on from Iconoclast on the Silencer. He wants to go for that. Can he do this though? Looks like he should be able to, but he is gonna be scouted out if he went on the high, on the low ground. Rune being scouted out, but it's gonna be Bane that picks it up. But the Magnus not really wanting it. His bottle is still being brought towards him. It's gonna be a full bottle anyway, so not really needed. He does pick up his mana boots, though, the Magnus that is. Gonna go for his Blink Dagger next, I would say. As we have got Cut coming in for Eros Loco again, landing some harassment. The Surge Away should be enough, though. Curse is still there. Might be enough to force him back, but the Curse is only level 2, so it's not really that great, especially not since Eros Loco has got a Soul Ring, so can just spam out abilities anyways if he's fast enough. Queen of Pain 38-3 in her last hits, being forced back away a bit. 27-3 though upon those. The last hits are making a big difference in his mid lane for now. Maybe they can kill him off again though with an RP, with a Nightmare perhaps. As top lane is getting pushed slightly, TP is incoming for the Silencer. We saw clearly looking for that Eclipse, but the TP gets cancelled. Silencer is gonna stick around on the top on the bottom lane instead. Queen of Pain goes down mid lane still though, RP being used for that together with the Brain Sap. That was a kill waiting to happen, but not really all that exciting kill, I have to say. So we're gonna see what the top lane is here gonna do, because we know that Curly is looking for that Eclipse. We already saw him moving forward a moment ago. So if they get a Sun up on that Rubik, they should be able to get something done here. Iconoclast also roaming around continuously. He's not getting that much experience from the lanes, but he is roaming around for all the kills and trying to get those numbers up, because he has been in all 3 kills so far. Looking for a Nightmare again. He's gonna try to find it. He should be finding it. Here he goes. Boomski, where art thou? Hello, CXE. This might be not the right place. Sonic Wave, but the Stick Charge is helping out. Eclipse going through with the tower. And the Scream. Queen of Pain getting a kill up on the Luna. TP in also from Cheshire Cat, who gets some Malefice up on the Bane. He can't TP out. He will drop. That is 2 kills for the price of 1 support Rubik and not even taking down a tower. It's not worth it for 4 FT. And all of a sudden, it's 3-4. You can't really expect to dive a tier 2 tower and not have anyone TP in or come in to help defend that. As we're gonna have an Invis rune up on Nose, who's still building towards his Blink Dagger. Probably not gonna try to leave his lane all too much unless he's either getting shut down heavily or he can find certain kills elsewhere, or his team really needs needs him somewhere. But until he has a Blink Dagger, he'll be sticking here, I'd say. As we have got Moon still farming as well, he's got his armlet as good as complete right now. We'll see him with that one soon. And Nick, he's not yet level 6 yet, so not got that big impact on the game as of yet. He has been getting some experience on the top lane, but not as much. He couldn't really stick into that much experience range, as it looks like we're gonna have rotation from 4FC. Wards being placed upon wards. And sentry wards instantly. Hello, ward. encounter that. The creep wave, of course, came by when they saw them being placing that one. And we're going to see if they can try to take down a tower. Because what, they have three people here. Why not try something? Well, okay, why not rotate? Since they're scouted out anyway. Maybe they just didn't want to be there anymore. And they have got a smoke in their inventory. They're going to place a sentry first, though. They could smoke if they really wanted to. That sentry actually scouts out this one. But you have to be having some vision up on the high ground before you can see that. So hopefully before OFC they will will soon have someone standing around there to take that ward down. In the meantime, on the top lane, it is this Cheshire Cat that has decided to stick around after getting, of course, a kill. But, or an assist, I should say. But yeah, he's going to be able to push down the tower. He's, of course, a hero that we sometimes see on the off lane more often, just because of his pushing power and his denying. He backs off, though, but... if only they could watch the minimap, they'd realize that they might still have a chance to kill off that Enigma. But the rotation comes. Illusion room picked up by the Magnus. And it's gonna be the Enigma that goes away. It's gonna be the Enigma that backs off. And now they're gonna be too late. In the meantime, Queen of Pain finishes up her bracer. And of course, has got her bottle again in the courier. But that's not really exciting. No, still happily farming. And he's gonna be able to continue to free farm for a while yet. And then he will have his Blink Dagger. In the meantime, on the bottom lane, it looks like there's a gank being set up for Eros Loco. Who is sitting very safely and is with his vision that he has and realized that there's people coming for them. And Power Rangers apparently not realizing that, well, since their ward got countered, they should maybe try to check if there's a ward for them, but oh well. For now not really already there. And Eros Loco is just gonna continue gaining experience. He's level 8, not doing too bad. Only level Radiant behind on the life zero. In the meantime, top lane, three people pushing in. Fortification Radiant's goes off, and Enigma's here again, though. Attack. Do they have enough pushing power to take this down? There will be also a Queen of Pain coming in as well as a silencer. TP incoming from the life stealer as well, and there comes EXE looking for that Bane. Bane looking for something, but gonna get a Malefice and gonna go down. He's the only one, though. Sacrifices for the team. Take one for the team. In the meantime, the tower is gonna get denied. And Moon, but the tower still drops. And the mid tower also getting a lot of harassment as the courier is gonna bring the Blink Dagger towards Nose. Bottom tower is under attack. And there's two towers down on the side of Power Rangers. Well, there's no towers down yet on the side of 4FC.
Radiant's bottom tower.
And ZXC going for a drums by the looks of it, as we have the mechanism being built up by Eros Loco, who's gonna be able to surge himself away from that Queen of Pain. Ooh, nice link. Stolen haste from by Nose. He's actually gonna try to chase Nanique with that one. Should be able to do that. Telekinesis, though, drops also up on Iconoclast. Blink away, shockwave, only all that's needed. There we go. Picks himself up a kill. Killing spree for Nose. Do they wanna go for more? Do they wanna try for more? They see Kat here. They also only have to have a Fiend's Grip up on him, and he will drop. Iconoclast now coming back, but I think it's a bit too late. It doesn't seem like it's needed anyway. Double kill for Nose. Haystrun MVP. Now it says Shire Cat's gonna be next, but he has got a black hole. But he does realize that Iconoclast is around there as well, though, so he can't really cast a black hole without a fear of getting interrupted. And there is gonna be Nose in a lot of trouble, and there's a Sonic Wave. This should be a kill. Nose, he doesn't have a haste when he doesn't have a blink again in 1 second. There he goes. Nightmare up on the Enigma. No Malefice helping out. But Queen of Pain realizes, hey, there's the Bane there. That's a free kill. Level 10 versus level 6. I wonder who's going to win that one. Iconoclast finding himself a Malefice still. Going to be with three people there and will be going down. But hey, he gave his life again to a teammate with the Nose able to get away. I would say that is quite worth it. Gonna have the gold graph slowly but steadily going towards 4FC. Now, one thing, of course, is that is two kills in favor, as I already said, but that's about 3k gold. So imagine the gold on the side of 4FC to still be free to pick up for Power Rangers. When they start pushing, they will have the advantage, as we have got Boomski scouting out the observer ward. Doesn't want to stick around, though. Realize that there's people around him. If he should try to go for that ward, he will probably not be in a very good position. We're gonna see Iconoclast going for that instead. I'm gonna look for that nightmare, perhaps. Fiend's Grip up on Kat. Surge up. And that's gonna be Kat going down. Shockwave and Dragon Slave. All that's needed. Now the ward is picked off. And maybe now they can try to push down a tier tier 1 bottom. In the meantime, it is still Luna that's free farming. They're basically, they're doing the whole 4FC thing, like, four actually, the like, with the name. Four friends? Like, really all alone. That's their Krilly farm and the 4FC, even though with the stand-in, but he is their manager, so I would assume he's also their friend. Just doing stuff in the meantime. TP's incoming, Malifaz up on arrows, Loco gets open wounded as well, but has a search up, so we'll be able to get himself away. TP incoming also from Nose. Infest is still gonna be there. Nose, he has got a blink there, could try to go for it. Tower still drops, but it doesn't look like 4FC wants to really go on in on this anymore, and not after only his moon to try and take down. It's not too, it's not enough anymore to put all the effort in for. Krilly on the run. Oh, he wants to go for it. He can dive the tower. Eclipse actually going up, and this is gonna be a kill. And it's gonna be a kill for who though? Krilly picking off ZXC. Cheshire can't able to get away, but wow. That was some nice reaction speed. He is still gonna go down. Has 3 stick charges. Oh, hello, Eris Loco, mechanism savior of the day. And that should be Krilly out safe and into safety and into the base again. Unless he's gonna try to farm the small camp first. Looks like he's gonna do just that. Just to make sure he doesn't waste any HP then while he's still there. And he has, of course, got Tranquil Boost, so in theory, he doesn't even need to leave. But he doesn't have any mana left anymore, and I think that he wants to farm with a bit of mana, I'd say. But yeah, he gets himself a kill, so very nice, nicely done for that. He picked himself up at Ogre Club, going for that BKB. Can pick up the Minthor Hammer already, as we have got more rotations coming off from 4FC, going towards the bottom lane once more. They have got, of course, a tier 1 tower down here already, but maybe they can find some people that are farming in the jungle, like Moon. If you see that your opponent's carry is not on the lane, on the top lane, not farming on the bottom lane, not farming in the middle lane, well, then he must be somewhere in the jungle. So they're gonna try to find him. They have got, of course, the Fiend Script. They've smoked up looking for him. And they're gonna be able to find him. They see him soon. There he comes. There's a Fiend Script. Gonna be hitting. Boomski able to land a stun, but the rage is way soon. Faster, that is. No, still coming in with an Invis Rune. Has got an RP, but the rest of Power Rangers already beckon themselves out of that. Out of there. We've got 3,000 gold still in their favor. Even with now an extra tower. But of course there's also a tower picked up on the side of 4FC, as in 4FC has lost one of their towers. Gold-wise, we have got Luna up ahead, together with Nose from net worth. 1,800 gold already up on the Magnus. Malifaz, Apanera's Loco, just harassment though. Telekinesis, Fadebolt. Actually, this could be a lot more than harassment. This could be a kill mechanism. Sonic Wave misses, though. Hello, RP and Skur. And the black hole gets casted. Eris Loco now goes down, but on the sidelines, it is Khan and ZXC that go down. And Iconoclast is going to be able to get away from that. Open wounds up on Boomski. He's 3 hits, and then he's dead. Noah's going to be able to survive, but 2 for 2. And the oh, actually, it's 2 for 3. Nice infest damage done on the Bane. Double kill for Moon. But they did pick up the Queen of Pain and the Silencer, so it's not entirely lost. And Cheshire and Cat, that could have been a lot better for Power Rangers if that black hole actually caught out the Enigma of the Magnus as well, but he couldn't do it. As Rubik tried to steal the reverse polarity, actually I got only a shockwave in return. Actually it's level 4, it's not bad. Like I said, it's very hard to steal bad spells from 4FC at the moment, but it's not the spell that you want to be having, of course. You want to be getting that RP. Moon is gonna be going for an MKB by looks fit. Maybe a Basher actually. Would be very nice, of course, if he knows that the Luna is gonna go for a BKB. You want to be able to continue to harass her and to stop her from attacking. A Basher would of course be very nice to have. And then Nick with a haste rune going towards the mid lane and want to defend that tier one. Tier one who slowly but steadily dropping with Krilly there as well. Sentry being placed just in case. Also Ward of the High Ground. And they will be trying to go for this surge up. There's Loco. They need a creep wave though. They can't afford to tank up the tower at this time. They do have an RP again in 9 seconds, and of course that's the main difference between the RP and the black hole. RP is just has a way shorter cooldown, and on top of that, it is level 2 and that definitely helps as well. Of course level 2 black hole as well, don't get me wrong, but it's still it makes a bigger difference time-wise for the Magnus than it does for the Enigma. Or am I talking crap now? No, it makes 10 seconds difference for both. Well, boohoo. Tower goes down and the Blink Dagger picked up by the Enigma. It's gonna be a bit better initiation for him. Gonna not be having any more black holes where he doesn't catch that Magnus anymore, I think. Moon in some trouble. There's Loco looking for him and can't find him. And he's gonna just TP mid instead. There's a 4FC. They're doing the whole 4FC thing again. I mean, they have got Krilly on the top lane with his BKB complete, with his Animitis. And they got now three on the bottom lane with Iconoclast moving around and probably gonna try to stack the Ancients or something. Of course, that's something that you can do for the Luna. She is one of those heroes that can clear those stacks really fast with her Bouncing Blades. We're gonna see Boomski continuing towards the bottom lane. This is quite risky for a solo Lina to do this. Radiance, but apparently he feels safe enough with attack. The sentry wards around there, and of course the ward here as well. Because normally you don't see Lina up this far. And both teams seem a bit at an impasse. Like, It's a bit of a not large ancient stack. It's a bit of a stagnated game. So we have got a lot of team fight on one side, a lot of team fight on the other side, and both teams are very well aware of that fact. So both teams seem to be quite happy with the way things are going, with just having their carry farm and having the rest of the team, you know, getting ready in case something happened, but not really initiating anything. More like trying to pick someone off if the chance comes, and otherwise not doing anything. And of course, 4FC is a bit ahead, but just by a little bit. This is not enough to really play extra ballsy from, because it's 4k, but it's not really that much. If we look at the level difference, we have got level 14 up on Krilly, who is the highest level in the game. But it's still, the levels are fairly even, and we see that back in the experience graph as well. I mean, this is basically no difference whatsoever. 500 experience is nothing. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Looks like 4FC still wants to try and lay down some pressure on bottom lane, though. Not because they want to take down the tower, but purely because they want to force Power Rangers away from their Luna. If they get a tower, nice. Worth it. But it's not needed. Just having all of Power Rangers here would be nice as well. Fiend's Grip, Moon! He's gonna be taking a lot of damage, Laguna Blade, and he's gonna get picked up before he can rage! Oh, there comes the Black Orc! Cheshire again looking for it, Fiendscape got stolen though! And it's gonna be hitting on Nose, Scream, see what's on two Nose, taking a lot of damage, will probably be going down. There comes the Black Orc, it's on Eros Loco, but alone on him! Light Strike away, Ray into nothingness, and Boomski gonna be going down as well, 3-4-1, and that one bought back. But like I said, well, it's not really worth dying for, but they do force everybody from 4FC away, and that gives Krilly a bit of a chance to actually start pushing a bit on the top lane. He has got himself Boots of Travel, and is of course one of the faster heroes in the game, so can just run himself away from this. But yeah, it's not good for 4FC, but it's not too bad. I mean, they'll lose a tower, that's not good. That is actually the worst thing that comes from this. Gonna be losing the gold advantage that they had, even though it was a very slight gold advantage, it was still an advantage. Now Nick got 1300 gold in his inventory, let's see what he's gonna buy with that. Maybe a fourth staff or something like that, as we have got Moon. His basher is complete. He's got 1k gold. And we'll find out what he's gonna go for next. Maybe a Desolator, but we'll see. It really depends on what he sees that Luna's gonna go for. Luna's got 2k gold in her inventory, so maybe he doesn't want to pick up anything before he does that. As we do have a bit of a rotation for 4FC, looks like they want to prepare for taking down Roshan. Sentry wards placed everywhere. This is quite obvious now that they're gonna go for Roshan, though, because of course the wards were there for the Radiant team as well. But then again, they don't have a black hole to fight with. Maybe they're just confident in just giving it away and be able to take it down, take 4FC on later anyway, because they have that black hole. And is Luna picking up the Aegis? Their Scottish accent. In the meantime, Queen of Pain did take down the top tower. So they do get something in return for that. That was, by the way, the last year when Tara was still standing in the game. Wow, sorry for that. We got 1500 gold again. I'm really curious to see what he's gonna buy. Is he gonna buy a Ghost Scepter perhaps? But that's not really a good thing to have. Not when there's a Luna on the board. And, well, Lina and Luna actually. Of course, Eclipse as well as a Laguna Blade. So I'm quite curious to see him not picking up anything just yet. Of course, the Mechanism Force team is already on the Enigma. I was going for that BKB to continuously cast his black hole. Though, it's not guaranteed. The RP can still interrupt that black hole. So it hurt. Well, Enigma's job is, his job I would guess, is to get that Magnus inside that reverse polarity or make sure that that the RP is on cooldown. As we have got an Enigma Sealing Shockwave. And Noah's actually going for the Refresher, of course. He picked up a Perseverance, also has an Ogre Club, so could be going for BKB first. But I think Refresher is going to be the one to go. And the rotation from 4 of C again inside that Radiant Jungle. They really want to be here. Power Rangers. Still, this game, it is very even. I mean, I'm just going to break it down to you again. There is nothing is going to happen until one of the two catches someone out, like just now. But the BKB gets popped. And, oh, ZXC actually trying to go for someone with a Sonic Wave. We started doubting about going in. But 4FC, like that's the kind of stuff that we're gonna see. 4FC looking for pickoffs, Power Rangers maybe sometime looking for pickoffs, but big head on teamfights? At this moment, both teams know that this game is still very even, and one wrong teamfight can just shift the whole game into one direction that you don't want it to be going in. So unless you're certain you're gonna be able to take the teamfight, you're not gonna take the teamfight. Unless you are indeed certain that you're gonna be taking it, and it looks like ZXC is gonna try it because he has got that Lifesteal inside of him and he's looking for a pickoff. If he can pick off Matron before going in, then he might be able to amount to something, but he's actually gonna be jumping himself out. You're gonna give up the tower. No fight being done here, and 4FC backing out with all five heroes there again. And it's gonna be Luna going for the Yasha's going for the Mantisel. And we'll see what they're gonna go for next. And not, I don't mean itemized, I mean for like the thing is, the reason why we see 4FC now more on the map, on the side of the map than Power Rangers on the side of 4FC snap is because of that Aegis. They've kinda got a failsafe. But they still don't wanna be throwing a game because of that. Throwing a team fight, I should say.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Don't get me wrong. Everybody loves to see good team fights, right? And this game is definitely a game where we can see those with a black hole, with an RP. I mean, you have it all. You can even have the Rubik sealing the RP, and then you have like and a black hole and an RP, Sonic Wave over the top. You know, it can all happen. But as long as these teams are assuming that the game is even, which it is, I mean, I get it, I don't blame them. They're not going to be the one to try and go in first without knowing exactly what they're jumping into. And for now, neither teams know that. So they all try to just profit from other people's mistakes, and for now, they're not finding any openings just yet. We do have ZXC continuing to farm. He's got 1600 gold in his inventory again after getting his black hole ready. We've got indeed the Desolator being built up by Lifesteal, by the looks of it, picked up in Mintral Hammer. Talking about Mintral Hammers, Enigma wanted one as well, and he gets himself his BKB complete. Maybe we're gonna see something happening with that, but... Oh, Infested and Smoke Up. ZXC, they're gonna try for this. They can just walk past this and try to go for a backstab, or they can just jump right in and pick up Frilly or something. No, they go for Iconoclast again. There is a Fiend's Grip up on the Queen of Pain. No, still gets the Sonic Wave up. Bing goes down. Black Hole gets casted. No, it's a Frilly locked inside there. No RP this game. No RP this fight anyway. There goes the Aegis here. Iris Loco getting picked up, and the rest of 4FC getting clean out. Frilly, last one alive, drops himself the Eclipse, but it's just for show, because nobody is gonna go down on Power Rangers. Power Rangers take a huge fight. And that is the reason why I said that you don't want to be going in for a fight unless you know absolutely sure what you're going into. Power Rangers knew what they were going into. And they caught 4FC by surprise. They weren't ready for that. The black hole was perfect. Well, it was only getting two people, but they got the two people that mattered. They got Krillie and the Magnus. The Magnus did not get his RP off. The only downside is that the fight happened all the way on the side of Power Rangers' side of the map. Well, kind of here. And that kind of means that they're not going to be able to get that much in return for that fight, because by the time they reach the towers of 4FC, 4FC will be back alive again, and they can't really do anything anymore without walking in through a trap, because there is still a reverse polarity on the side of 4FC, so you can't really go in on the opponent team knowing that your opponent has that big team fight potential and you don't. So that is definitely something to take into consideration for Power Rangers. And they indeed back off, gonna just continue to be going for the previous state of the game, which is farm. Yay! Fun times. I've got a gold graph, I mean it goes back a bit to 4FC. I think it's gonna be a bigger difference on the experience graph, because of course that was 5 kills in the favor of Power Rangers. And Power Rangers is gonna be ahead. Boom! Someone's building a tree in that graph. It is going to be 7,500 experience. Now, we know that one team fight can just drop it back down. And you know, experience graph are always a bit more drastic than the gold graph. But it is a steep, steep lineup. That has to be known. Of course, the biggest difference in the levels that we're going to see is that just... Not even just one person, because it's still the Luna that's ahead on 4FC for all the levels. But it's going to be just gradually more experience with Power Rangers. With the level 17 and 16s up on all those... well, the Queen of Pain, the Enigma, and the Lifestealer. With just level 15 and below for the rest, apart from the Luna, but Luna is a special case. And Luna, of course, she did die previous game. Like, the thing about Luna is she's a great carry, don't get me wrong. But she does need to be able to just stand there and hit stuff without everybody of the opposing team being able to shut her down. And that is exactly what they did. They were able to shut her down with the black hole. She couldn't hit during that fight. She couldn't do anything during that fight. And her team couldn't get anything done during that fight either, as there is another smoke up for Power Rangers. It looks like they want to go for it again. Can they pick up that Bane again? Can they go for that Magnus again? Can they pick him off before he can do anything? He does have a black hole. No, hello, Bane. Bye, Bane. Matrim just getting clean out right there. Or Iconoclast. Whichever name you prefer. And Power Rangers is able to continuously pick him off. And that's going to be them getting a bit more ahead. Not just because of that kill. I mean, so it's only a support Bane. But they do make sure that 4FC kind of feels like they're in a position that they can't take a team fight, while Power Rangers is. So they can take something in return for that. And they can take the tower, I think, because I don't think 4FC wants to fight without their Bane. That Fiend's Grip is so important to shut down either the Queen of Pain or the Lifestealer. I mean, you can deal with one, but dealing with two is just very big. It's not very simple. And the BKB, like I said, BKB up on nose, and he needs that. He needs that because of the silencer. That is what silencer does in this game. The threat that knows is gonna blink in, skewer, and go for an RP, and getting silenced halfway so that he can't get his RP is just too big for him to deal with. So he wants to have that BKB to make sure that he can get his RP off, silence or no silence. And Desolate already up on Moon. Guess it was ready for the previous fight. It's got 1700 gold in his bank already again. Blink Dagger being purchased by the Rubik. Now Nick getting that one and has 1600 gold again. As we got the Queen of Pain going for a Sheepstick, I'd say they need to shut. Like I said, Luna is great if she can hit stuff, but if she's not going to be able to hit stuff, then, you know, she's not going to be able to do anything. So more shutdown is always nice. So that's going to be a Sheepstick to make sure that Luna is not going to be able to do anything, or the Magnus is not going to be able to do anything. But both of those have, of course, a BKB, so they can have that period of time where they are just invulnerable for those hexes, and they can just try to kill out the Queen of Pain before anything else happens. At the same time, Queen of Pain, she's got a BKB as well. Now the upside for 4FC is that they have two abilities that actually go through that. Oh my god, they're gonna go again. But who are they gonna go for? Oh, Matrim. Oh, Krillie. That would be trouble if they actually get him. Double damage picked up. She runs herself to Roshan. They realize this is going on, though. And if you get a blink black hole in that Roche pit, of course the Roche, well, right now there's only two people in there, but a clumped fight is amazingly good for a black hole, as well as for an RP though, so don't get me wrong. Blink in, scream, doesn't get anything, Krilly, double damage rune, able to harass, vacuum back in, here comes the Eclipse, so the BKBs and the raids get turned on, so Krilly not even being able to do any damage whatsoever, knows, still standing on the sidelines, and it's gonna be a silence that helps out there. It is gonna be Rubik that goes down already. The BKB up on nose, looking for a RP, can't find it. Can he find one? Oh, Fiend's Grip to shut down the Enigma. Iconoclast, there's the RP. It's on two. Nose backing off, lands a Shockwave. It's gonna be the Queen of Pain that gets put in a Nightmare, but still lands her Sonic Wave. Krilly is gonna get dropped. It is gonna be Moon that's gonna get dropped again as well, though. Boomski landing a stun upon the Queen of Pain, who's gonna be able to blink herself away in 2 seconds. Shockwave doesn't hit anymore. Buy bags for everybody. Luna buys back, Lifestealer buys back, Enigma buys back, Rubik buys back, everybody buys back, and it's all of a sudden 5 versus 5 again, but then without all that team fight potential, all the people that were still hanging around are gonna be at a disadvantage. That kinda means that the team that had the most buybacks is actually kind of in favor right now, because they have more heroes that don't have to go back to base to heal up, because they come back with full HP and mana. And that means kinda Power Rangers, because Power Rangers is the one, of course, to have more buybacks. So god, I gotta sneeze, but it doesn't. I don't have to. This is my brain, things it does. It's annoying. Oh well, it's over again. So this is gonna be Power Rangers trying to go for this. We already have got the smoke up again. 4FC, they want to take this, but look at this. Boomski still on half HP. Telekinesis, Eric Loco comes from the wrong side. Gets a vacuum up on three. No, he's gonna land a shockwave from the low ground. Pops a Nightmare off from the Queen of Pain, though. And that doesn't really help Eris Loco. There is the BKBs in the blink for it. Picks up Eris Loco. Boomski cannot do anything with all those BKBs going around. And it's just annoying for him. Losing beams to it on the Enigma. And both teams back off once again. Buyback from Eris Loco. Could he still? He still had that.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Queen of Pain sitting with an invested lifestealer. Oh, Boomski. RP though, up on two. Queen of Pain and Moon, the two most important targets. Gonna take them down before they're up again. Fiend's Grip is gonna lock down someone, but it's already over. It is gonna be Kat that gets skewered and goes down as well. Can they find more? Enigma is still there. He doesn't have a black hole for another 55 seconds. And Rubik only got the Dragon Slave, gets the Illusion Beam on his face as well, blink forward for nose. Can he get something done? Iron Shell doing a lot of damage here as well. Nanique is gonna go down, Eclipse still going through, but it doesn't matter, everybody's already dead. Now maybe they can get for Roshan, because now there is no buybacks anymore from anybody up the Radiant, apart from the Silencer, but, you know, he is a Silencer that is a support. And that is gonna be Roshan. Finally going the way of 4FC. We have the kill score still slightly in favor of Power Rangers. I think the experience grab is gonna be able to tell us more about this. Well, this very long fight. It was basically a fight that lasted. Well, lasted so long that there could be 2 RPs, basically. Well, both teams dancing around each other for a very long time. We have got the experience grab dropping back towards the zero line, still slightly in favor of Power Rangers, but not by any kind of amounts that would be worth mentioning. We have the gold graph going the way of 4FC, but 5k gold with still 2 towers left to be picked off for Power Rangers when they get to it. It's not that big of a favor, not that big advantage. We have the net worth though, and this is even showing it more. Like, you have got the 5k gold difference, right? There is already a 5k gold difference between the Queen of Pain and the Luna, so all the gold difference is in that Luna. So that means, it's not bad, it's definitely not bad, but it kind of means that if you shut down that Luna, and they definitely, like we already saw, they have a Hex, they've got a Black Hole, they've got Silences, they've got Telekinesis, and everything that the Rubik steals, they got as well. If you shut down that Luna, there's nothing 4FC has. At least not has over you, though. So that's a big difference right there. She did pick herself up a Butterfly. So we might see a MKB being picked up soon by the Queen of Pain after her Hex, but we'll see if she's gonna be going for that. Of course, you wanna be able to hit. Oh, that's a real one, and she can't blink away. That's really dead. But her Aegis is at least still there, and here comes her team. Power Rangers realize that, so oh, they are gonna be on the way out. Vacuum doesn't hit anything. Cheshire Cat doesn't have his blink still, so can still blink away. And they're gonna be able to back off, but they did pick up the Aegis real quick. Clean and simple. The Finley has another empty inventory slot, so maybe he's gonna be happy with that, that he can still buy something. In the meantime, Cat, he needs to be getting a bit more items up as well. I mean, the later games go, the more important those supports are gonna be, and more importantly, the more important the supports that can actually play a kind of a semi-carry role are gonna be. And Silencer is one of those heroes that can actually do that. Bane cannot really do that. He is a single target hero. His strength lies in the disable of the Fiend's Grip of the Nightmare. And just hanging back and doing just that. Maybe a Brain Sap. And of course, Enfeeble is gonna be really nice up against the Lifestealer. Because it actually goes through BKB and Rage. So it's a very nice thing to have upon him. But it is not gonna be a semi-carry. Same thing goes for, of course, a Darkseer, though Darkseer should not be neglected either. He's a utility hero, still very strong. Boomski, same story, utility hero, though he does get shut down so heavily by that BKBs, all those BKBs of all the teams. With them on, he really cannot do anything. His last hits do nothing. There's no damage whatsoever. So, on semi-carry heroes, they basically only have the Magnus, and then, of course, the main carry, Luna. That's what 4FC is building on. Well, for Power Rangers, they have got the carry, of course, the Lifestealer, who's sitting inside a Queen of Pain, who is a semi-carry of her own. And then they have Silencer potential, which could, in theory, become a semi-carry as well, with just Ruby being a utility hero, and Enigma being a utility hero, of course, as well, with the Black Hole. And they're gonna try to find Gridley again, but this time he was away in time, and the Infest already goes out, just because Moon didn't want to stick around there any longer. Three heroes of 4FC on the bottom lane. Being forced to TP back by the looks of it, because their tier 2 mid is going to get pressured here. There's a fortification, it's going to get used. Are they going to try to go in on this? There's a hero sitting on the high ground. There's no ward up here for the Dire side. And the Black Hole gets casted, it catches two. Blink forward, knows. Gonna get hexed the moment he comes in. Didn't pop his BKB, has got a refresher though, but goes down before he can do anything. There's an RP, there he goes down. A Calypse being used still. Laguna Blade hits up on the Lifesteer and goes down, and it's gonna be Power Rangers that gets cleaned out. Blink away from ZXT, but he's gonna get blinked after by Boomski. Losing Beam helping out. There's even a Satire helping out as well. Still 55 HP left on ZXT. Three heroes already dead for his team. He doesn't want to be the fourth, but Luna, fastest hero in the game. So close, yet so far. Queen of Pain blinks herself out into safety as Sheera Cat is gonna be back on the bottom lane to push things out. They did lose that Magnus though, and with that RP, His RP made a big difference, don't get me wrong. It definitely helped out for his team, but it would have been such a difference if he didn't get hexed before he went in. He had his BKB, he turned it on too late. He turned it on after he blinked, which is basically not something that he should be doing currently. Gonna be taking some harassment from the tower. Last strike array up on the Queen of Pain. Queen of Pain, you just survived the 55 HP. Don't go down right now. You're just gonna lose your tier 3. Accept it and live with it. Can't do anything anymore, the rest backs off. They don't get any racks, but the tier 3 is at least gone. More gold on the board for 4FC as we got. We're going to 8k gold advantage for them right now. Experience graph is going to be dropping a bit more aggressively right now. Not just because of those kills that just happened, because of course Power Rangers did some kills of their own, but more importantly because they kind of forced Power Rangers into their base for a while and they can't really farm as fast, or they can't really go back to farming as fast as 4FC can, so we're gonna see it drop down towards 2,500 experience going the way of 4FC. Still, that's still not that big of a difference. For the people wondering, by the way, we have got a Navi coming up after this game versus El Pride, with games after that with Mouse Sports and No Tidehunter, and then there's gonna be No Tidehunter versus versus something else, and then it's gonna be Navi versus Mouse. Basically that. Oh, 3D Clan versus No Titan, so that's gonna be the second last one. It's gonna be 4 games after this one for Star Series, and of course, I wanna say it again, I know that a lot of you people, you know, would prefer listening to me if I have a co-caster. This guy will be my co-caster after this game, so you can look forward to that. You can, of course, flame him with his score, because he's actually on a negative KDA. He has 2, 6, 11. Shame on you, Matrim, shame on you. Though he prefers to go under the name of Iconoclast. And the reason he's called manager is because he is the manager of 4FC. 4FC, they... I guess they feel in favor enough of this game that they can actually go for this, because they are all 5 here. Then look at their positioning. If that... Enigma comes close with the black hole. That would be quite the thing to. I mean, this is it's a good black hole position for Enigma, I would say. Who has a gem? Oh, Quina. Lina, that is. Quina? Really? Yeah, Lina has a gem. So that's counter wars being done. But are they actually gonna go in with this? Are they really gonna try? They have still got the RP and the refresher, so they've got two RPs. And there's gonna be a Roshan soon up again as well. Well, soon. 2.5 minutes, 3 minutes, sort of. They're actually not gonna fight. Probably we're not gonna see a fight until the Roshan comes again. And by that time, we're gonna also check who has buyback and who hasn't. Because that's gonna be very important as well, just like it was last time. And by that time, everybody's buyback is off cooldown again. It just matters on if you have enough gold. And I think that Moon, at least, has got enough gold. Unless he goes all in. $5.1k gold up on Cheshire Cat. What are you gonna buy? I think he needs a needs a sheepstick or something. Sheepsticks are always good, especially if you know that your opposing team has only got one real hero that you need to shut down. Well, two if you count also the Magnus, but I would say one at least. Moon gonna work top, gonna be finding himself the Bane. So he saw him walking there, so he TP's out, and yeah, that's gonna be Curly also backing out. He finished the Satanic. Still has his hand of Midas. Could be sold when he gets the Aegis. If he gets that Aegis, because that's going to be the question. We have got wards placed again by the Radiant side. They have them all around here. It is nighttime though, so with the Gem of Truce, they can't see it from the sidelines. Or can they? No, they cannot. They should not be able to. They're going to check, however. Maybe he saw that one. Yeah, there he goes. They don't see that one though, but doesn't really matter. Doesn't really matter at all. Moon just farming bottom, 3,500 gold. Cavalry has arrived. Illusions. Nova. I'm really wondering what that Enigma is gonna buy. Cat, in the meantime, he could use some of that gold. He's got for the double brace ability. He just wants to survive. Sheshaka has to be careful. One pickup right now could mean the difference between Roshan and no Roshan. What are you gonna buy? Buy something. And it's just illusions pushing out the bottom lane. And even those illusions are doing quite a bit of damage. Don't underestimate this. They could even pick up some buildings if they really could try. And those buildings give a lot of gold. Look at this! Half the barracks down, and with the distraction, 4FC is actually getting the better of the Roshan. Well, looks like we're not gonna see a fight over Roshan. Sorry, people. I know that a lot of people were hoping to see a fight, but no. Cheese falls as well, though. It's gonna be the cheese for the Luna and the Aegis for the Magnus. So RPs aplenty. And maybe with this, they will try to go for force a fight. But then again, everybody of 4FC or everybody of Power Rangers is ready for it. And I mean, that black hole could turn everything around, just like an RP can. And especially if you're gonna go push up the high ground, then the positioning for the RPs is gonna be like a bit better. You can see where you're gonna go. Your opponent is normally just standing in a very small entrance of your base, so they make the mistake of stacking up a bit more often. And Nick actually is gonna buy something. There's a sheepstick that's ready, off the bat, and he doesn't have buyback. He goes all in with that sheepstick. I'm not sure if that is the right choice, but we'll find out. The Mantis Style Illusions will be able to help out this pushing. Krilly doesn't have to put himself in danger. Gets the Malefice, gets turned into a Piglet. Has got cheese still though, but needs to have the chance to hit it. There he goes, RP up on three. There is another RP incoming as well though. Knows where is it? There it is. And that is gonna be Cat going down, Moon going down, but the black hole catches three. And there is another. Black Hole, by the looks of it. Sorry, another RP. That was a Rubik's RP. That was it. ZXC gonna be having to run away from this one because the damage is still too much. It is gonna be buyback for buyback, but 4FC, they're just going for barracks and they can actually do that. And they are backing out after cleaning out the barracks. Don't lose anything apart from Eris Loco, who actually bought back but doesn't want to know where, doesn't know where to go. Can't be back inside for the fight anymore. The Aegis was not used yet. Nose didn't go down. Fiend's Reaper was used, of course. And that's gonna be a lot of people that died. Actually, the Moon died, bought back. It was Cat died, bought back. Eris Loco died, bought back. So three buybacks, two on power range, one on 4FC. And of course, I mean, MKB ready. The Black Hole was great, and the RP that got returned by the Rubik also. But there, at that time, Moon was still on the way back. At that time, Moon was still walking back towards his team, because he only just died and bought back. And he wasn't in time to deal damage in return for that RP. Like, the disables were perfect, but there just wasn't any damage to go through. And 4FC should count themselves lucky for that, considering it is, of course, it was a fight on Power Rangers' base. And if you have a fight on your opponent's base and they are going to be buying back, they should, in theory, be back very fast into that fight. But apparently, the timing from Power Rangers is just not all there, or at least... Well, you can debate that. Like, should they have waited for Moon to get back, but then have the risk of not having the good Black Hole? Should they have backed off a bit more to have the chance of 4FC still picking up the barracks without a Black Hole and the RP casted? I'm not sure. And the go goes again after Kat reconnects back in. And we have got, what time is it? Ooh, we are running out of schedule right here, because of course, after this, like I said, Naviel Pride, they should be already waiting in the lobby, so don't be expecting me to sit in the end screen for all too long, because we need to see Naviel Pride, and you're not going to be missing that one. Russian / Ukrainian showdown. And of course, on paper, Navi should win, but El Pride, they've really been able to get some good results as well, so... Don't already judge that game before it's over. Looks like we're gonna see a bit of a, well, race. I think that they're gonna try to see if someone comes to defend that, but I think she's actually gonna need to TP back to base and try and help secure their tier 3. And there she is indeed, TPing back. And Curly gonna turn into Piglet. But nobody does anything, and here comes actually the RP from Nanique. Gets turned into a Piglet himself. Again, not enough damage to go through. And Nanique pops his Ghost Scepter. Oh! That is why you don't pop your Ghost Scepter, but Laguna Blade is still on the board. Lucid Beam to go through as well. Look at these bouncing blades. They're forcing back Cheshire Cat and Cat himself. Without even doing anything. We have got Luna still getting picked up. Though Moon doing that. Fiend Strip from low ground up on the Moon as well. Can they do enough damage? Krillie is back. He's picked himself up a Daedalus. We got back here very fast with this boots of travel, of course. And that is gonna be another set of racks down, and the GG gets cold, and it will be 4FC that still have only 4 losses to their name. And I'm gonna say it again because, well, personally, I have to be honest, I'm not expecting it to happen. But in theory, it can happen. It can happen that 4FC, together with Navi and Empire and Mouse Sports, we'll have a 4-way tie for one spot to go to Kiev. But more on that later, because we are going to jump ourselves into Navi versus El Pride. Stick around for that game. My name is Sheever. If you want to support me, subscribe to my YouTube on youtube.com/SheeverGaming. You can also follow me on twitter.com/SheeverGaming, twitch.tv/SheeverGaming, facebook.com/SheeverGaming, and all that jazz. And check, of course, my website, SheeverGaming.com. We're going to be seeing another game of Dota 2. We're going to have co-caster Matrim with me, or Iconoclast, the Bane of this game, should be here. So stick around for that. We'll be right back.